Assalamu alaikum students, the topic of my today's lecture is listening. Today I will talk about listening as a skill and the importance of listening in communication and how does listening have the repercussions and consequences for making communication effective or ineffective. Here this is the outline. We will talk about these different things about listening. Some I would talk today and some I would take up in the next lecture. So moving on, we would start with the importance of listening. And we see the percentage of time that we spend upon listening as compared to the other activities. We see that we spend more time on listening than we spend on writing and reading and speaking. And if we see the thing, like we are talking about the importance of listening, why there is a need to talk about the importance of listening? The need is because most of the time we take the difference, these skills of reading, writing and speaking is more important than listening. We spend more time on improving these skills and we spend, I won't say that we spend less time on improving listening skills, but I would say that we don't actually see that there is a need to work as listening as a skill or we need to improve listening skills. So we see that there are different kinds of training workshops and classes being conducted to improve the writing and the reading and the speaking, but I have not seen that there are any kinds of workshops or training workshops or classes being conducted to improve the listening skill or to work as a work at listening as a skill. We don't see listening as a skill because we tend to confuse listening and hearing both, though there is a marked difference between both of these. If I would say what is hearing, hearing is a physiological process. That is a physiological process of detecting sounds. That's a physiological function of our auditory sense. And hearing is an automatic process of perceiving sounds. Whereas listening is not a physiological activity, rather this is a psychological attribute, a psychological attribute of discerning what is being heard, of trying to understand and trying to make out what is being heard. So what is hearing? Hearing is a passive activity, whereas listening is an active activity that's not passive. Hearing is unconscious, automatic process which is going on and on and on, whereas listening is a very active pursuit. It demands hard work. This is a conscious and active process of eliciting information, ideas, attitudes and emotions. When we say that this is about eliciting not only information, but listening involves getting ideas, attitudes and emotions in any communication situation. So because communication, what is communication? This is a dynamic process. This is a two-way process. It involves both the speaker and the listener. And if the speaker is doing good, but the listener is unable to grasp the intent of the speaker, then definitely that's going to lead communication towards failure. That the communication won't be successful if the listener is not doing his job. So what a listener has to do, listener has to not only grasp the information, but he also has to grasp the ideas behind that information, the attitudes in which that information is being shared, as well as what emotions are being involved and what is the intent of the speaker. Then definitely taking into account all these factors, they would help the listener to come up with the right decision, to come up with the right choice and to draw a right conclusion. But if he is unable, he is not grasping the complete information. I mean to say that if this is happening, that the listener is maybe eliciting, maybe getting the words, but he's not getting the attitudes and the emotions and the feelings and the intents of the speaker, then definitely he is not getting the complete idea, the complete information. And if he won't be coming up with a complete idea and complete information, he won't be able to take a right decision. So definitely if there is a poor listening is going to lead you towards poor decisions, poor negotiations, poor relationships, poor professional relationships. So that's what makes listening is a very important activity, a very important skill, which is actually going to decide about your career, about your success. If you are a good listener, so the chances are that you would be successful. Then the next point says that the speaker and the listeners are interrelated, and an effective listener therefore must assume some of the responsibility for effective communication. There is a need to say this thing, because most of the time this is seen that the listeners withdraw, listener is passive, listeners don't assume the responsibility of the communication. We already have talked about this fact in barriers to communication, and we had said that the speaker is responsible for effective or ineffective communication, and the listener know that, but the listener must try to assume some responsibility and try to help out the speaker in making communication effective, and the listener could do that, because good listeners always exert a positive effect on the speaker, and the good listeners always has the speaker to improve his or her effectiveness. Because if the good listeners come up with good non-verbal feedback, if the good listeners are there to encourage the speaker, if the good listeners are there to, if the speaker is not coming up with the right thing at some moment, then the good listeners are there to guide the speaker. Good listeners are humble and patient when they are listening to the speaker, and they are cooperative. For that matter, that would help the speaker. That would encourage the speaker. That would give energy to the speaker, so that he may carry on with the communication. So there is a interrelationship between the speakers and the listeners, and the good listeners always, if they are the good listeners in any communication situation, the most of the chances are that communication would be successful. Moving on, this is the page I have taken a book. I would also tell you about the source of that book, and here I want you to go through these pages. If you could get hand at the soft copy of the book, and if you could not, you may just zoom it and you may read that. And you would see the very first thing that it is that it says is that listening requires more intelligence than speaking, and that's a Turkish proverb. Interesting. You may ponder over that, and then you may come up with what does that mean? Like, why do listening require more intelligence than speaking? The next process of listening has been described, and in that process of listening, they say that listening, most of the time we have kind of ideas about listening, and we assume that listening is sometimes merely that means maybe maintaining the polite silence, and that would show up that the listener is getting along, listener is following the speaker, and sometimes we are rehearsing into our mind what we have to do, what we have to say next, and we are assuming the polite silence, and the next person would see, okay, the listeners are actually getting along, but that's not listening. Secondly, this also quote an example from a professional situation where it says something about the boss, and where the bosses are unable to listen to the employees, and where they are unable to grasp the intent of the employees, and how come if the boss is unable to listen, how come that results in kind of poor relationships in organizations, and how come that employees withdraw and employees lose their interest, and that results in unsuccess. And there is a very interesting quote over here by Charles Kettering, and Charles Kettering says that we can communicate an idea around the world in 70 seconds, but it sometimes takes years for an idea to get through 1/4 inch of human skull. I just want you to ponder over that and see what does that mean. Like, most of the time, but this is my experience, according to my experience, I see that this is very, very much true. This happens, that the idea has been communicated, it has been passed on, and superficially, maybe sometimes we might think that we have grasped the idea, but interestingly, most of the time this happens, that most of the time don't grasp the idea at that moment. Sometimes it takes months, weeks, months, sometimes years, to understand, to grasp the complete idea. Yeah, this happens. Most of the time you would see, okay, in my case, what my teacher has said during my bachelor's, I came to understand right at this moment. I just got it and got to know, okay, achha, ye matlab tha unki is baat ka. So this happens, that the idea has been communicated, but to grasp the full meaning, the complete meaning of that idea, that sometimes demands years and years. And afterwards, you grasp the complete meaning of it. The next heading that talks about the misconceptions and myths associated with listening, and the very first myth that is associated with listening is that listening is the same thing as hearing. Though this is not the case, as I already had talked about this thing, that I'm not going to repeat that, that hearing is a physiological process, that is something which is passive activity, which is automatic process, which is going on and on and on without any effort on the part of the listener. Whereas listening is demanding, that's hard work, that's very active process, and listening is not merely listening to the words, but also listening to the attitudes, listening to the emotions, and listening to the ideas, listening to the intent, and so on and so forth. So most of the time listening is being not being given importance, because that's being taken as something which is an abstract process, an invisible thing, our subjective experience. You can listen, nazar nahi aa rahi hoti na. स्पीकिंग में हम वेट कर सकते हैं कि अच्छा जी ये कैसा स्पीकर है, ये कैसा राइटर है, ये कैसा रीडर है, लेकिन लिसनिंग में हमें सामने नजर नहीं आ रहा होता, दो नजर आ रहा होता है थ्रू द रिस्पॉन्सेज. लेकिन हमारा मिसकॉन्सेप्शन क्या है कि जी लिसनिंग नजर नहीं आती, इसलिए नो मैटर वट एवर वी वुड डू वी वुड गो ऑन, नो 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 प्रॉब्लम. बट दैट्स नॉट द केस, रादर दिस हैज द डायर कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज इफ यू आर नॉट अ गुड लिसनर. And the second thing is, the second misconception associated with listening is that it's the same thing as breathing. So what is so special about listening? That's not the case. This is not an automatic process like breathing. Hearing is, but not the listening. Then the third point says that all listeners receive the same message. That's not the case. All listeners might hear the same message. The same sound would be coming into their, would be received, the same sound would be received through their ears, but the same sound would not be interpreted in the same meaning by all ears, by all brains. So that's not the, all listeners don't receive the same message. So here there is another example being quoted by the writer, and he gave the example that that is being associated with developing the proactive interest, because they say that listening is very demanding activity, and it demands not only full attention but also a proactive interest in what the speaker is talking about. So that also has to do with the proactive interest. So this is interesting example given over here, where they gave the example of a guest speaker who is talking to a group of students, and some students, they are enjoying it, they are getting along with the speaker, and just because they had developed their proactive interest. And there are definitely always a few group of people who don't have interest, because since they were unable to develop a proactive interest in the communication at hand, definitely then they were not going along with the speaker, they are not following the speaker, and as a result they had tuned out, they had withdrawn, and they are uneasy and they are not enjoying. So this happens. So this also makes it a little obvious that grasping the concept and having an interest in the communication, they both are interrelated. Like sometimes it happens that when you are not grasping some concept, you lose your interest. But what I think, most of the time it happens that if you don't try to develop your interest into the communication or the interaction at hand, then there are the chances that you won't grasp the concept. Because if you would have proactive interest, the chances are that you would be able to grasp the concept. So the thing is that firstly, this is important to try to develop an proactive interest and try to develop an interest into the communication, and then you would be able to grasp the things and grasp the concept, and it would maintain your interest, and then you would enjoy the communication and situation because you would be successful in getting along with the speaker. So the reading source for these pages is Lena Sen's book, Communication Skills, the second edition. If you could get hand at the soft copy, well and good. Otherwise, try to see it through these images. The next is the process of listening. The process starts with sensing the thing, with sensing the sounds. So sensing the sounds also means receiving the sounds, hearing the sounds, and then selecting out of those sounds only those which seem to you relevant. Because In sensing, we sense so many sounds. We are a part of some communication and we are taking part in that, and we are very much attentive and focused on that communication. But there is noise around, there are many sounds which are coming to your ears, which your ears are receiving, which your you are sensing. But that does not mean that you are going to receive all those sounds, to select all those sounds, and to pass all those sounds to your brain for the further process. Because hearing is the physiological process of sensing the sounds, perceiving the sounds. And when those sounds are being sent, being transferred, and being passed on for the further process,